Warning.
This compilation of our podcast may include spoilers for film and television. Surprise. And it also may include some explicit content to cover your ears, little kitties, because it's about to get fucking wild. So to speed up a little bit of time, we're going to move on to my favorite part of the evening, and that is film and TV trivia.
Now, is this just going to be trivia based off of the movie that we watched, or is it just going to be just overall basic generic?
Well, unbeknownst to you, I have included two questions based on the movie.
Okay.
And it's kind of just whatever you want to do. If you want to include questions about the movie, you can, but
yeah,
I didn't try to include all five, like make them all about the movie, because that'd be kind of boring.
Yeah.
So I'm going to ask you five questions, and if you get them right, if you get more than half right, I'll suck your dick. Okay, first question.
Okay.
What?
I hope I get them all wrong. Go ahead.
What is Daniel Radcliffe's favorite film of his?
His favorite film? Like that,
yeah,
that he's done?
Yeah, that or... he acted in.
That he acted in. I'm going to say... I'm probably going to say it's one of the Harry Potter films. Just guessing. I'm going to say... I'm going to say number four, just because that's my favorite. I don't really know. But okay. What was it?
It was Swiss Army Man.
It was actually Swiss Army Man. Okay.
Yeah, that was his favorite film that he starred
really?
In. Yeah.
Okay, well, that's cool.
And there's actually just a little side comment. He's actually starring in a new movie where I forgot what it's called, but it's a character who has guns for hands.
Okay.
It looks really good. And
do you know what it's called?
I don't remember. If you just look up Daniel Radcliffe and
you
guns for hands.
Yeah.
Yeah. But that does look like a good movie and I want to watch it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, for sure.
Next question. For Swiss Army Man, directors Dan Kwan and Daniel Scheiner said they wanted to make a movie where the first what makes you laugh and the last what makes you cry.
Let's see. The first
blank makes you
laugh,
and the first blank makes you cry.
I would say probably the first. Are they going to be the same word? Are they going to be different?
Yes, they are the same word.
They are the same word. Okay.
I'll give you a hint. It's like the main focus of the film.
Mm-hmm.
It's one of the important things that happens in the movie.
Mm-hmm. Gotcha.
It happens at the beginning and happens at the end.
Gotcha. I'm just like trying to think. It's like, what would make you laugh and cry? Like the first, because it happens.
Well, I guess focus on what would make someone laugh that was in that
which
movie.
Which would be probably the fart, I'm guessing.
Yep. And that was the correct answer.
Cool.
It was the first fart makes you laugh and the last fart makes you cry. The first time I watched it, I believed I cried, actually.
Okay.
Because it was just a heartfelt moment.
An emotional time. Mm-hmm. It was. All right, what else you got?
Third question. Who was the first female monster to appear in a movie?
Oh, wow.
Like, it's kind of easy. There aren't too many female monsters.
Yeah, I guess not. I'm just thinking, like, back to, like, because this is going back to the beginning. Like, first, mm-hmm.
It is a black and white film.
I'm going to say, what is it? Bride of Frankenstein.
Correct.
Nice.
Good job. Ding, ding, ding.
Heck yeah. I'm just that good.
All right. Number four. The first movie given the title Blockbuster was which film?
First movie given the title Black... Oh, I think we might have gone over this history. I think my teacher's going to be mad at me. we might have fashion. I don't know. First Blockbuster? I'm going to say... Gone with the
Wind. What'd you say?
Gone with the Wind.
That is incorrect. I'm sorry. Got? It was Jaws.
It was Jaws. Okay. So it'd be later then. Okay.
Yeah. And since it's not just film trivia, we got a TV trivia at the end.
Number
five. Yeah. In Seinfeld, what superhero is depicted in every episode with an image or a reference?
Oh, shit. I don't know this one. I'm going to say... Since clearly I don't know it. Superman, I guess.
Wow. Good job, Henry. You got it right, dude.
That was Superman.
Really? Yeah, you got it right. Sorry, I didn't know that I was gonna make that clear.
Yeah. No, I just figured you're gonna make a joke like, wow, Henry, you got it wrong. Okay, wow.
You got totally guessed. I need to watch three or more, so I guess I put it in our contract that any punishment that we put into any prize you win during trivia has to be completed or else you're fired. So I'm sorry, Henry, but this has to happen.
No, it doesn't. I am exiting the company.
So this next little bit is our trivia segment, which we'll do at the end of the podcast to just share some little fun facts about movies, and including the one that we watched. So I have, I think, seven here right now.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Four of them are about Ex Machina. The others are not. Two of the other ones are about film, about movies, and then the last one is one about television. So, okay. You ready, Miles?
What's my prize? What do I win?
If you win, then you get to spend one evening with wife.
With wife?
Your wife, yeah.
Why not yours? I want to spend...
Fine, you can spend a night with my wife. She's invisible, though, and also smells like garbage, so...
that's kind of rude. It's a little rude.
She's non-existent, so it's...
Okay.
Yeah. That's the other thing, is that I'm not a married man.
Oh, yeah.
The contrast. No. Okay, If you win, you get to spend one free night with my wife. All right.
Does that sound fun? Okay. Cool. That sounds fair.
You guys can do what you normally do when you're by yourself.
All right. We try not to talk about that with you, Henry, because.
Okay. You know what? I thought we were a team here, but all right. Okay. All right. Let's just do this. okay. So first question. Is about Ex Machina. So, Ex Machina is loosely based on which play by Shakespeare?
Oh, fuck. I'm only gonna say this because of the title of the podcast, but Macbeth.
Actually, you're right.
What?
No, I'm kidding. It's actually The Tempest.
God damn it, Henry.
Love you, though. three main characters, Nathan, Ava, and Caleb, all correspond with people in that play. Obviously, it's not about artificial intelligence. It's actually a thing about a magician. Nathan, the creator of the AI, corresponds with Prospero, who's kind of the main character, and then Ava corresponds with Miranda, who is the daughter of the magician play.
Mm-hmm.
And then Caleb is Ferdinand.
Mm.
And so that's interesting.
Interesting.
If you enjoy the play. Anyways, if you enjoy reading Shakespeare. So, next one. What three colors are most prominently displayed throughout each scene of Mass?
Hello?
Are you still there?
Yeah, I'm still here. I didn't, you kind of like, yeah, I think so.
What three colors are most prominently displayed throughout each scene of the movie?
Red, white, and blue?
Close, actually, yeah. The first and the last one are right. Actually, it's red, green, and so.
Oh, RGB.
RGB represents the color model, you know, used to display images in computer systems. And, of mm-hmm. course, you know, Ava is technically a computer. So it kind of accentuated that. I thought that's kind of why I mentioned the color stuff. Was that was pretty cool and interesting, I thought.
Yeah.
Especially the more that you actually do in, like, for example, or editing, and you do like color balancing stuff, you kind of mess with those three, and so it was interesting to. I thought that was an interesting fact. Okay,
mm-hmm. Yeah.
So now we're going into TV for a second. What year did the animated series The Flintstones first air?
I'm gonna go with 1969, dude.
Good guess, you're in the right decade, but opposite end of the spectrum. So the answer is September 30th, 1960. And actually, man. Believe it or not, Fred Flintstone first appeared in an unaired pilot a year earlier, which is called The Flagstones. But then, obviously, like I said, that never got to air.
Yeah.
Because they changed it to The Flintstones.
Interesting.
So, next one. Director Alex Garland, director of Ex Machina, is a fan of this 1979 Francis Ford Coppola film.
Oh, I can't remember any of his movies.
His work. The Godfather, man? No, it's not The Godfather, but although that is pretty famous. The answer is Apocalypse Now. So.
Oh, yeah, I haven't seen that one. It's on my list.
I guess the guy that they're trying to find in the film is Walter E. Kurtz. He was a former colonel in the U.S. military during Vietnam, basically. And that's what the movie is set in, based on. And he's played by Marlon Brando. And there's, I guess, Alex wanted to draw similar ties between him and Nathan. Because mm-hmm. both of them seclude themselves in, like, this wildlife. And then both of them sort of have, like, a little bit of a god complex at times.
Yeah.
Or seem like it. So, there's kind of some interesting parallels between them, which I thought was pretty cool.
Interesting.
Okay. Let's get the last Ex Machina one, I guess. The movie takes place in Alaska, but do you know where the outdoor scenes were actually shot?
No, I don't.
So,
you're asking me a regular question.
What, they were shot in Norway.
Norway?
Actually. Yeah, of all places.
No way!
Yeah, Norway.
Get it?
I get it. I thought it was
okay, cool. Good.
Let's see, have you seen the movie Army of Darkness?
Dude, that's like my life.
Yeah. Look at this one then.
Go ahead.
What does Ash refer to his shotgun as in the film Army of Darkness?
Boomstick.
His boomstick, that's right.
Yeah. I know that one. I think that's the only
one. This is my boomstick.
Yeah. I think that was like the only one I got right.
Yeah, I think this is a little too hard. I mean, you know, I'll give you, like, half credit for the color one, because you got both.
Yeah, half credit. So, I
three
don't...
quarters.
Yeah. Is that all the questions?
Yeah.
Okay, so I guess I didn't...
Okay, like I said, she's non-existent. That's too much.
What?
Like I said, my wife is non-existent. I won't be missing much, but that's okay.
Okay.
I'll just, like, draw, like, a picture. It's like, here you go, this is my wife.
If you send me a drawing of your wife, I'll put it in the YouTube version of the podcast.
Oh, that'd be funny. I'll do that. It'll just be like a stick figure with like these crappy ass like hair like or something.
Oh yeah, I'll put it in. I'll do it. I'll do the whole shebang if you want.
I'll just like give you like a picture, and then like I'll show up at your house, and like the picture will be like on the table with like an alcohol bottle next to it or something. I'll just be like, "What did you?" Yeah, that's all I had for trivia.
Okay, that was good. That was a good test.
I actually have a request for you.
Request? Yeah.
Can we call this segment Act Trivia?
Act Trivia?
Yeah.
In the future, yeah. Yeah, we
can. Maybe we can get sponsors, too.
Mm-hmm.
But we can get sponsored by Activia.
Act Trivia.
Yeah, because I could. Yeah.
Yeah, no, I got it. You've made that joke before, Henry.
Yeah, but not on the podcast.
True, not on the podcast.
Not on the air.
Okay. Why don't we, I guess, move on to my favorite portion of the podcast.
Oh, yeah. Let's do
that. And that is Act Trivia.
Yay, we did it. Nice job.
Yeah. I wrote it down so I'd remember.
Good man, because I didn't.
All right. So I've got 8 questions here.
8 questions?
Yeah. One more than your measly 7.
You know what? I thought it was a good number. Okay.
No, it was good. You're good. I was like, I want to do 5, but I don't want to be shown up by Henry.
We'll just each do more and more questions each time. Like I'll do 9 next time, and you'll.
That would be horrible.
20 by like our 10th podcast.
That would be horrible.
Go ahead.
All right. So, before, because it's tradition, let's see, for your prize, if you win, right, you get a jar of cucumbered, because as you know, you can cucumber things. It's the reverse pickling.
Reverse pickling.
Yeah. So I guess reverse pickling sounds better, I guess. You get a jar of reverse pickled... I'm looking around my room right now and coming up with something very funny, I promise.
A potato blue. Very funny.
A jar of reverse pickled tissues.
Reverse pickled tissues?
Yeah.
Be a funny band name. Mm-hmm. Miles and we're reverse tissues. Nice. That sounds good. that reminds me of this meme I saw on Instagram, or it's like this video. The caption was like, "I can't believe the ingredients on this are amazing." It's like they put on like the meat or whatever, and like the cheese and the lettuce and the tomatoes and everything, and they start putting pickles on there. And I remember thinking, how are they gonna fit like this sandwich together? There's so much stuff on there. And then they just started putting more and more pickles on there, and they took like a jar and just like threw it all on there. It's just like buried in pickles. I'm just like, okay.
I'm pretty sure that was How to Basic.
Was that How to Basic? Oh.
Yeah, I think that one's on YouTube.
Is that?
All right. So are you ready?
Yeah, Captain.
Are you ready to win a jar of reverse pickled tissues?
I am not. Go ahead. Do this.
Okay.
If the tissues are pickled, can I like re-pickle them?
If you want, yeah, but you're gonna devalue the product.
Well, that's okay, but then I can sell it.
For less.
Less. So no problem. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. First question. Ryan Gosling replaced which X-Men actor in the film Drive?
Which X-Men actor?
Yeah.
I'm going to say... I'm trying to think who's all been in X-Men. What's his name? I guess I can't think of it. It's Hugh Jackman.
You are correct.
Wait, really? Oh.
Yeah, yeah. Hugh Jackman.
I was thinking of maybe... I was thinking it was either going to be him or maybe, like, the guy who played Scott or something like that.
Oh, Michael Cera?
Michael Cera. Wait.
What?
Michael Cera? Was he? I'm thinking of... Or,
Scott. Cyclops. I thought you said Scott Pilgrim.
Scott Pilgrim. He was an X-Men, yeah.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Could you imagine?
Oh, man, that'd be... That'd be pretty
him
good.
Stabbing people. Wearing that, like, fake police mask thing. Yeah.
Police what?
As the cop, yeah. Go ahead. Next question.
Okay. Number two. Drive's tagline, "There are no clean getaways," is the same as what 2007 film?
Baby Driver. I don't know. Let me think. It came out in 2007.
And this is a film you have seen.
I have seen it.
Mm-hmm.
Know that. There are no clean getaways. I would like to take a 15-minute recess.
Oh, that's fine, dude. You can just throw out a guess, and I'll tell you if it's right or wrong.
I gotta remember what films I've seen.
And what films I know you've seen.
And, yeah, that you know that I have seen. Like, Ex Machina. That's like, yeah. I'll just say I'm trying to think of it. How about Transformers, I guess, or something.
Transformers? No, that is... I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
What a surprise.
There are no clean getaways. Transformers. No, it was No Country for Old Men.
Wait, really? Oh, wow. for that. That's like my favorite movie. How did I not know that?
Wow. I didn't... It is your favorite movie?
Yeah, I think so.
Wow.
Yeah. Ethan's gonna be so disappointed. Alright,
Okay. Number three. So now the first two questions were about Drive, but I couldn't find enough on Drive, so the rest are just kinda random.
Okay.
Stanley Kubrick made the cast of The Shining watch what movie to get into the mood for filming a horror film?
The cast of The Shining?
Yeah. And I'll help you out. The Shining was made
that was
in
80, hold on. Right?
Hmm?
The 80s?
I think so.
Late
something 80s?
Like that.
Yeah, 80, actually.
Oh, it was 80.
Yeah.
So before that, what movies would be horror? Obviously Frankenstein. I think. I think, because slasher films probably would have been after that.
I mean, there were some slasher films, I think.
Were there before 80?
Before that, yeah. I'll give you another hint. It did come out. I don't even know if you've actually heard of the film that I'm referring to, but
okay.
This film came out like only a few years before The Shining came out.
Okay. I know this is wrong because I think this came afterwards, but I know what you did last summer.
Yeah, no, that definitely came out after.
Yeah, that's like, is that 80s or 90s?
I think that's possibly, yeah.
Okay.
Hold on. I know what you did last summer. 97.
Okay, yes, yeah, so definitely not.
Yeah, so no, that is incorrect. I'm sorry. Okay. The film was Eraserhead.
Eraserhead?
Yeah. Have you heard of that one?
Yes and no. Like, I've heard the name, but I don't.
I haven't actually seen it, but I've heard it's weird. Okay. It was directed by David Lynch, so I know, yeah. David Lynch is pretty, yeah, good at you know, yeah, what he does. So,
hell yeah!
But I have heard it's weird.
Yeah.
All right. So you got that one wrong. You might get. No, I'll just continue. Whatever. During the filming of Zombieland, Woody Harrelson was arrested for what?
During the filming, let's see. What did he do?
It's a pretty small crime, so.
Oh, so maybe minor thing. Okay.
Yeah, something minor, not like killing someone or anything.
Right. Just like, kill someone. Just, I'm filming a movie. All right, it's fine.
All right, I need to get back to the set.
Walks out of like a bar or something. It's like all bloodied up. Like, it's fine. It's fine. I have
it's for the movie. It's for the movie.
Arrested for. Public urination.
No, I'm sorry. That's incorrect. It was marijuana possession.
Marijuana possession?
Yeah.
That's about right. That makes sense.
Yeah, yeah, okay. I wasn't marking which ones you got right.
I only got the Hugh Jackman one.
Okay, so you only got that one right.
That was the only one.
Yeah.
Because I had Transformers, I Know What You Did Last Summer, and Public Urination, so I'm pretty sure I'm not getting a good track record.
So oh, it's ahead. Okay. You decimated me last episode, so.
That's true.
Hopefully you'll get this next one right, though. I feel like you should.
After the No Country for Old Men debacle, I'm feeling pretty low, so we'll see.
Okay. In Parks and Rec, the map of Pawnee is a flipped version of Muncie, which is in what state?
Isn't that Indiana too?
Correct.
Yeah. Nice.
Ding, ding, ding.
Yeah.
Good job. I thought that was a little easy, but.
Yeah, no, it's.
With your brain. I'm kidding.
No, it's a valid point to make. And there should be no surprises to how little intelligence I truly have. So continue.
Okay. The actors in what movie used the book How to Talk Minnesotan to help with their accents?
Fargo.
Correct.
Nice.
Did you know that?
That's the only movie I can think of where it's in Minnesota. Yeah. It's the only one I've seen. I'm pretty sure, and that takes place in Minnesota, which is, it's a great film.
It is pretty good.
Good old Steve Buscemi.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's his ear taken up. You've seen that, I'm sure. Right?
Yes, I have.
That's a great one. I know a lot of my friends prefer that one over No Country for Old Men, but I don't know. For some reason, I think I just like that one better than Fargo, although Fargo is definitely a close second. So.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways, continue.
Oh yeah. Side note, I did read while I was looking for these questions. I did read that Steve Buscemi, I'm pretty sure, ad-libbed pretty much most of his lines for that film.
Oh really?
Yeah, it's an interesting fact. Yeah.
Yeah. Did you also the first time I watched it, I was paying attention to the credits and like how in like the beginning or whatever, it's like talking about how it's like it's based on real events, and then like it says like these are all, and then at the end it says like the typical these are all fictitious and in no way represent real happenings or whatever. If they are, then it's pure coincidence. And it's like, okay, so which is it? And I had to look it up, and they just like never give a straight answer on the Coen brothers, which is I think pretty ballsy. But
yeah,
continue. Okay. Next question, Judge.
Number 7. What show featured an episode with Donald Trump as a primary character?
What show?
So it's not the show. There's a specific episode of the show which guest starred Donald Trump. And this is a scripted show, so it's not like Celebrity Apprentice or something.
Right. It's like you said, like just one episode he was just like a cast member with the rest of them.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
But I think he was playing himself, which is a little weird.
Was that what he was doing? I don't know. Family Game, I guess.
Incorrect. No, I don't even.
I don't know.
He might have. Yeah, I don't know.
It probably wasn't him though. I mean, voicing it or anything.
Yeah, it was. Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Oh, he's in Fresh Prince.
Yeah, I actually looked at like some screenshots from.
Yeah. Well,
not screenshots, but. Some pictures from it, and it looks very not good, but
yeah,
whatever.
Very not good.
Number 8, last question, Henry. Last all chance.
Right. I'm pretty sure I didn't win those reverse pickled tissues anyway.
Yeah. Okay. Which animated adult show was banned in China? I just noticed I put in twice. which animated adult show was banned in China in 2006?
Which animated adult show?
Yeah, I was trying to make it clear that it wasn't a kid's show.
Was banned in China in 2006. Futurama.
Incorrect. It was The Simpsons. The
Simpsons? Why was it banned? Do you know?
No, I don't know. I can.
They were just like, fuck the Simpsons.
Yeah, fuck definitely. Fuck yeah. The system.
Fuck the Simpsons. This is a system. Yeah.
Okay, let's see. You got 3 out of a possible 8 right.
I needed 5 to do it, right?
I would say 4 at least, or 5.
Curses.
I was gonna do the math before, but I forgot.
It's okay.
Thank you for trying, Henry, but you did not get the jar of reverse pickled tissues. I'm sorry.
Damn it, this show was rigged.
It sure feels like that.
Yeah, it does. What are you trying to get at, Miles? Do you really hate me that much?
That the system is messing with us, man.
You can't trust the system. Anything else?
I don't think so. I think that'll be it for now. See you guys next week.
Yeah, thanks for coming to the podcast.
Yeah. you wanna introduce our next segment?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miles Bowden on the next episode of X Trivia.
Hold for applause. Okay. Okay.
Okay. So now, Miles. If you get... Okay, so I wasn't going to do this because I was like, it's going to get old, but I actually put 9 questions on here because you had 8 last week. To be honest, that...
I'm not putting 10 in next week. I want you to know that.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Yeah, I don't want to do that.
That's a good idea. To be honest, I kind of took so long getting ready to record this because I was finding other ones I wanted to ask to get up to 9 questions. At least 2. Just 2, I think. Okay, although I do have some very lengthy questions. All right. So are you ready for this, Miles?
No. You have to give me what's my prize? You said last week that you had a really good prize for me, Henry.
I don't know what you're talking about. I don't have a prize. What are you talking about?
Henry?
Yeah?
You better have my goddamn prize, you motherfucker. Oh, I'm gonna come to your house and fucking kill you. I swear to God.
Wait, say that again.
I'm gonna come to your house
Oh. Nice. Okay. Anyways, all right. Okay. So I have a prize for you.
Yeah, you should.
It's sitting right in front of me, actually.
I'll
send you a picture at some point. Okay. But what it is hand
a big
soap.
Dildo. Oh, a hand soap. Actually, okay.
It's hand soap, but get this. It's not only is it musk-scented hand soap, but it is literally in the shape of a hand.
I'm not even kidding. It's in the shape of a hand.
What about that, like, is it a bar of soap?
It's like a block of soap.
Is it the one you used to have in your old room?
Yeah.
Okay. It's the same.
I saved it for a special occasion, which in this case is you winning at trivia.
I don't actually want it. I want you to keep it. But if I win, too bad. Oh, okay.
You have to keep it. All right. If you don't, I'm quitting the podcast.
Okay. What's my first question, Henry? So I can win this this handy bar of soap.
All right. First question. I have four questions about our film that we watched this week, and the rest are about either movies or television. So, First one. The film, The Men Who Stare at Goats, which is the movie we watched this week, includes three Oscar winners. Kevin Spacey, Jeff Bridges, and who?
George Clooney.
That's right. Nice job.
I figured, because I think he did a pretty good job.
Yeah. So, two, this one's also kind of simplistic, but the idea of Jedi warriors in The Men Who Stare at Goats is a reference to Star Wars. Which actor character was in a Star Wars movie?
Was it... Hold on. I think I know this. Was it Kevin Spacey? Wait. Ewan McGregor.
No. It actually was Kevin Spacey.
Dang it.
He played C-3PO, actually.
Oh, Jar Jar Binks?
Yeah. Yeah, he played Jar Jar Binks.
Wow. And C-3PO, actually. It was double duo.
Yep. No, you're right.
Okay, good.
Okay, good. Like, you thought you would get that wrong.
Maybe.
What? Okay. Now, step away from The Men Who Stare at Goats for a minute.
Mm-hmm.
What script for a movie that I know you've seen made it on the 2006 Blacklist, which is a list of the most liked unmade scripts of that year? Let me reiterate. So,
yeah,
2006 Blacklist. Yep, is a list of the most liked scripts that were unmade in that year. So, basically, scripts that were made in 2006 that didn't get made, but that were really well liked. Which script for a movie that you've seen made it on that list?
So the movie was made, right?
The movie was made. You've seen it.
Okay.
And I know you've seen it.
Can you give me a wee little baby hint, perhaps?
You've seen it.
Yeah, I know. I don't. That could be anything.
Okay.
Wait, hold on. Was the movie made in 2006 as well?
No, it was made after 2006.
Okay, that's what I thought. I don't know.
It was made 3 years later.
3 years later, 2009?
Yep.
Avatar.
No.
I don't know. Okay.
I actually tricked you. It was The Men Who Stare at Goats, actually.
Wow. You asshole.
I'm sorry. It's just some of these are kind of easy. I have to make it tricky. No. Okay. Okay. I don't know why I wrote this question down because it's kind of crazy, but I'll do it anyways. And, all right. In 2012, a Sight and Sound Directors Poll. In a 2012 Sight and Sound Directors Poll, director Quentin Tarantino listed his top 12 films, which are, according to that poll, Apocalypse Now, The Bad News Bears, Carrie, Dazed and Confused, The Great Escape, His Girl Friday, Jaws, Pretty Maids All in a Row, Rolling Thunder, Sorcerer, Taxi Driver, and The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. Which is his favorite of all time? If you need me to read the list again, I can.
Can you list just the ones I know?
I wouldn't know which ones you'd all know.
Yeah, I know. that was a joke. okay, let's see. You said Apocalypse Now, Jaws, Dazed and Confused.
Bad News Bears, Carrie.
Carrie.
Great Escape. It's Friday. It's Girl Friday. Pretty Maids All in a Row. Rolling Thunder, Taxi Driver, Sorcerer. And,
gonna say Taxi Driver. I know I've actually heard, like, the answer to this, but I don't remember it, so I'm gonna go with Taxi Driver.
Close. That's what probably what I was too. It's actually The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that is one of my favorite Western movies.
Oh, my gosh. This summer I was on a sophomore capstone project for my school. I was just helping her. My job was lighting, and so I actually had to study that film. They did what choices they made.
I love those movies. Hey, Henry, are you away from the mic right now?
No, I'm not away from the mic. Are you away from the mic?
No, I'm not. It's just you're cutting in and out again.
Oh, my gosh. I can't wait to get the new microphone. Okay. How is this? Better? Worse? Awful? Amazing? Is it still cutting out?
Not as much, but it should be
all nice. All right, I'll try to raise my voice. Okay, well, at any rate, what was the first horror film nominated for Best Picture?
Oh, man.
Came out in 1973.
I want to say, was it Psycho? No, that didn't come out in 1973.
It did not.
No, yeah, I know.
So you got that wrong.
I didn't. I guess I'll go with Jaws?
Good guess. No. It was The Exorcist.
Exorcist, man. That's like the second time I've gotten a question about The Exorcist wrong.
What was the first time?
It wasn't in this. It was in the other trivia I do.
Recount the actual story. Detail.
No. But it was like, what movie is the demon, you know, whatever the demon was from that movie from. And I thought it was Hellraiser. But no, it was The Exorcist, so.
Poltergeist.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right. Next question. What famous Disney actor starred as the title role in the 1992 film Chaplin?
I don't think I've ever seen the movie Chaplin.
Oh, shit. Sorry.
So I don't know.
Big Disney actor. Like
famous?
As in Marvel specific. Take a big guess. Because you know who Charlie Chaplin is, right?
Yes, I do know who Charlie Chaplin
is. Think who might be able to pull off, or at least looks like him. Who do you think? Take a stab at it.
Will Smith as the genie.
Is that your final answer?
No.
That's what I figured, but I have to be sure.
Yeah. You said 92, right?
In 92, yep.
Okay.
As in 1992, not 1882. 1892.
Is it like a live action actor?
It was. Yeah. It was a live action guy.
Like I'm saying, he was in live action Disney movies?
Yes, Marvel specifically.
Marvel. I guess I'll go with, I don't think this is right, but Robert Downey Jr.
So close. You are actually correct. No, missed out. Found it.
Is it?
Right. Yeah, it was
already. Okay, wow. That's such a weird role for Robert Downey Jr., I think.
He actually did a really good job, though.
Okay. Interesting.
Granted, I haven't seen it all the way through, but I've definitely seen the bigger parts of it, and he did a really good job, apparently. Because, granted, I don't really know. I mean, I've seen some of Chaplin's, the actual Charlie Chaplin's work, and I guess, according to his family, at the very least, they did a really good job of encapsulating kind of the comedic bits that he would do. So, it was one of his roles. Not that Tony Stark. So, right now you have 3 right. It's like, you need 2 more, and you get this bar of hand soap that you don't want.
Okay. Okay. That's good.
I'm just gonna be like dropping like subtle passive aggressive hints. Like if you don't want the musk, the musk scented hands of that shape like I am. Alright. 7. TV show time. What was included in the logo for the TV show? This should be too bad. For the TV show The Sopranos, to show it wasn't about music. What logo was included?
Isn't it a gun?
It is. Do you know what letter? This is. This is just bonus points. But
I think it's the P.
It's actually the R.
R. The R. Okay.
Yeah.
P and R are pretty close.
Close only counts horse grenades, as Andy Dwyer. All right, but you got that right. You only need one more out of these last two.
Okay, good.
All right. Tim Wasag, the man who stared at him, was directed by Grant Heslov. What movie did he co-produce that won an Academy Award for Best Picture? Director Grant Heslov, what movie did he co-produce that won an Academy Award for Best Picture?
I don't know that one.
Take a guess. Any movie. Pick a movie.
Any movie? Do you got a year?
No,
I mean, I'm not so good with years anyway, but
it's 4 letters.
Okay.
That probably won't help much, but kinda narrows it down. I don't know if you've seen it.
Do you know any actors that are in it?
Let me double check. Because
giving you extra work.
I feel I should have had that knowledge going into it, but whatever. Let me check, so I can give you some sort of assist here. Just watch me like say the movie like as I'm looking it up. Just like, oh shit. It's got Ben Affleck, Bryan Cranston. John Goodman's in it. Alan Arkin. I don't know if you know anyone else.
Oh, is it Argo? No, wait. Okay, I'll just say Argo. I don't think it's Argo, but
it is Argo.
Okay, wow.
You got it right. Nice
job. I know Ben Affleck was the director on that, but I didn't know it was co-directed by Grant, the other
Not directed, co-produced.
Co-produced. Okay. Then Argo. Cool.
Argo, yeah. All right. What major Hollywood studio? Last question. Number 9. Trivia bit. Question number 9 of the act trivia. Miles, just do my thing. What major Hollywood studio is responsible for the classic monster movies of the 1930s? I said that really fast, didn't I? What major Hollywood studio is responsible for classic monster movies of the 1930s?
Universal?
Yeah, nice job, my guy.
Well, that's pretty easy, because, the recent, not Brad Pitt, what's his name?
Bart Pitt?
Yeah, you got it. The recent Mummy movie with, what's his name? Jesus Christ.
Tom Cruise. Cruise. Yeah.
Yes, Tom Cruise. That movie. Yeah. They were trying to do the
They were doing the Mummy. Yeah.
No, they were trying to he was trying to do the Mummy.
He's trying to have sex with the Mummy, yeah.
They were trying to do like a monster movie verse.
Monsterverse.
Yeah, Monsterverse. They were calling it the Dark Universe or something.
Yep. The the Dark Universe.
Yeah, and so that's how I remember that, because the logo was like Dark Universe. Wow. So yeah.
So what was your answer then?
It was Universal Studios.
Actually, no, it was specific studios. The exact opposite. But sorry.
Okay.
I was
specific. The opposite of Universal.
Because like Universal could be made for like anything, but like specific is particular to one thing.
I guess.
I don't know. Right. What would you say is the opposite of Universal?
No, you're good. You're good. Okay.
I just work here.
So how many did I get right?
69. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. You got 6 out of 9. Hey, actually.
Okay, cool.
6 out of 9. Yeah.
Yeah, 69, nice. Indeed.
We were playing bingo. We were playing bingo at college. My college yesterday, and like the idea was if you won the game of bingo, you got to pick like a grocery item, because clearly college kids love free food. It's actually true. That's really true. Every time one of us, or anytime they called out, because we played a couple times, and if any time they called out 069, you would just hear like one specific table say "nice" like every time, and I thought it was so funny. They were my heroes. All right, anyways, because I'm mature. All right, yeah. So you get this musk-scented bar of hand soap. So
I get the bar of soap, but I,
even though you don't want it, you
politely
have to take
decline.
It. No, you have to take it. All right, you
I don't no want choice. It.
Hey, I wanted to decline the first prize from the first episode of Activia Trivia, but you know, and you still had anyway. To accept it. Yep.
Yeah, exactly. You got it anyway.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's something you want to say on air, online.
What are you talking about? What? Nah, but for real, I am delivering it to you. So
I really, I don't.
Yeah, you'll have to take it.
I can't tell if you're lying or not.
I can't believe that you know me that well to think that I would actually do that.
That's so awesome. You're not going to give it to me because I don't want it?
No, I'm going to give it to you because you don't want it.
Oh, okay. So now comes everyone's favorite portion of the podcast, and that is Actrivia.
Actrivia.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And I haven't mentioned this before, but I would, you know, why don't you folks at home play along and see how many you get right? Because I feel like that's something y'all should have been doing by now.
Mm-hmm.
If you aren't.
Slackers.
You know, play along. See if you could figure out the question before Henry and... Which you probably
will. Which will be fine. Yeah, yeah.
So I've included some different questions this week, something I haven't done yet.
Okay.
But first, there are 5 questions. I stuck to a pretty low number. Lucky for you.
I'm disappointed you didn't do 10.
I really did not want to have to ask you 10 questions. Yeah. Okay. First off, is a question about Godzilla, because there weren't many trivia questions. What was Godzilla called in Japan? So what was like his... What is the translation of Godzilla in Japanese?
Like, what's the word they actually called him?
Yeah, yeah.
I believe that was it Gojira?
Yes, correct.
Yeah, okay.
So that's correct. Where's my fucking pencil? Here it is. I got you, boy.
You grabbing your pencil?
Grabbing my pencil. Okay. So the next 3 questions are actually not even questions. They are log lines. You have to figure out what movie they go to.
What movie they go to? Okay.
Yeah, and one of them's a TV show, but yeah. Okay. I'm not going to tell you which one.
No. You're not going to tell me which one?
No, I'm not.
Why not?
Make it I thought maybe I'd make it a little bit harder.
Yeah, no, okay.
Sound like Adam Sandler. When he does his stupid voice.
Yeah.
It's not stupid. It's just not funny.
It's not funny.
Okay. Okay.
He's going to be on the podcast and be like, what the fuck are you talking about?
Yeah.
Right, anyway.
Okay. A man brutally murdered comes back to life as an undead avenger of his and his fiance's murder.
Weekend at Bernie's. No, okay.
And out of the 3 of them, I will tell you only one of them if it's a movie or TV show. So if you ask me on one of the 3, I'll tell you, but not more than one.
Okay. Yeah, so you'll tell me if it's a movie or TV show.
Yes, but only on one of
them.
Only
on one of these.
Yeah.
Okay.
As a hint.
As a hint. All right. Let's see. I don't even know him.
I can name an actor.
Okay, go ahead. Like.
Brandon Lee.
Okay.
That's probably a major hint, but
yeah.
No, it's not. not for me, at least. Let me think. Brandon Lee, because I don't...
You might have not even seen this movie. I don't think you have.
You told me you revealed that it's a movie, you fool.
Yeah, yeah.
Nah, it's okay.
I'll allow it.
He'll allow it. sorry to bother you. No. I don't know. I don't have an answer, my guy.
You're not gonna take a swing?
Nah. Well. Yeah, no, I don't even know.
Okay. The answer was The Crow.
Oh, The Crow, okay.
Yep.
Yeah, yeah, okay. Victims, ain't we all? Okay. Yeah, yeah. I got it. I get it. Okay.
These other
ones I have not seen that, but
yeah, I figured you did.
Yeah. You can probably tell. Okay.
Okay, so these other ones are probably gonna be okay. Number three.
Right.
An obsessed scientist assembles a living being from parts of exhumed corpses.
I'm gonna guess Nosferatu. No, I'm just kidding.
I think you say that every question. You make a joke and then you're like, "No, I'm just."
I don't do that every. I don't do that every joke.
Almost every
one. I do every it other. Every other one.
Yeah, exactly.
Fuck. Frankenstein. I'm gonna say Frankenstein.
That is correct.
Wow.
Specifically, the 1931.
But yes, that's what I was thinking.
You're good. You're good.
That's the only one I've seen, I think.
Yeah. Okay. Number four. In the unreal world of Sacred Heart Hospital, intern John J.D. Dorian learns the ways of medicine, friendship, and life.
John J.D. Dorian? Sounds familiar. Is that... that's Scrubs?
Yes, that is Scrubs. Good job.
I honestly didn't know if I was going to get that, to be honest.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so this last one is you get a name of some actors and you have to figure out what movie they were in together.
Okay.
You think you can do it?
Nope.
Okay, number five. Colin Firth, Jeffrey Rush, and Helena Bonham Carter starred in what 2010 drama? I believe this won some awards, and I will make sure on that. That might help.
Okay, could you say the names one more time?
Mm-hmm. Colin Firth, Jeffrey Rush, and Helena Bonham Carter. Let's see. This got an Academy Award for Best Picture, Academy Award for Best Actor, Academy Award for Best Director, Academy Award for Best Original Screenplay, a Golden Globe Award for Best Actor. So this was a pretty famous movie at the time.
Okay. Should I go that? I don't know what she was. I don't even know. I ain't got nothing.
You ain't got nothing. Okay. The answer was The King's Speech.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Okay. Okay. That makes sense. Because that was 20. Okay, that was 2010. Yeah, yeah.
Yep.
All right.
So you got three right. And I didn't. Excuse me. Sorry. I was like kind of almost vomited in my mouth. I didn't list the prize at the beginning.
Yeah.
For one, because I forgot, but two, because I didn't want you to know what it was. It's a pile of shit.
You're gonna say it's a podcast.
It's a podcast.
It's the podcast.
It's a podcast. No, no, dude, you get a big pile of shit.
Okay, I already have that. Thanks.
Just laying in your room.
What do you think I'm sitting in?
What do you think my seat is made out of, jackass?
My name is Miles Bowden, and welcome to Jackass.
My name is Henry Gage, and welcome to Jackass. All right, so Henry won Act Trivia this week. Good job, dude.
I'm impressed with myself, because I didn't think I would do that.
I made them kind of easy.
Thank you.
Because you're so fucking dumb.
I am. You're making a joke, but I am.
Right. And that is the joke, because you're not. Okay.
I am.
I think it's time for everyone's favorite portion of the podcast. Henry, take it away.
All right. We're kicking off tonight with some act trivia.
Ooh, well, we're not really kicking off.
Yeah, we're not really kicking off tonight. We've been like an hour into the podcast, but you know what I mean.
Mm-hmm.
So tonight I have prepared for all of y'all. I'm excited that we actually have two people for this now. I have
a real competition.
I have six. Hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 questions, and I will be asking you all of them. If you get at least three of them, I am awarding you with a gift card to Celebration Cinema, which I'm pretty sure is down here, so it's pretty much useless unless you come down here. But yeah. I mean,
that's the reason to go see you.
Exactly. Plot thickens. Anyways,
just like my gravy.
Ooh, I thought you were gonna say
but
something
you're
else.
Vegetarian.
Oh,
vegetarian
checkmate.
Gravy.
Vegetarian gravy.
Also
vegan gravy. All right, so we're kicking off tonight with 4 questions about
Room.
And then the other two are about movies, movie trivia. One's kind of a history thing, so
okay,
I'll be impressed if you get it. Now then, first question. How old was Jacob Tremblay when he played Jack in the movie Room? This is the kid now, remember?
Yeah. I'm going to say, I guess whoever gets it right gets to win it, but I'm going to say 8.
Connor?
Thinking.
And he was 5 in the movie.
Supposed to be. I think he was 6. No. Wait. No, that's not right. Go with like 10.
It was actually 8 years old.
Whoa, dabbing on these haters.
He was also too tall.
Yeah, he was pretty tall for a 5-year-old.
Yeah, that's true.
As long as it wasn't Brie Larson playing his role, then I think we would win.
Brie Larson's actually supposed to play a 5-year-old. Now then, on to the next question, which is probably a little more difficult. Who was the other actress that was considered for the role of Joy, aka Jack's mama, alongside Brie Larson?
Oh, we don't get any options?
No.
Yeah. No.
You have to come up with... No,
she was, they're good friends in real life. Let me think of some movies they were in, I guess. Actually, I don't know if I want to say anything because I feel like I might give it away.
Probably, but, yeah.
Yeah.
I was going to say Scarlett Johansson.
Okay, good guess. All right, Miles, what do you think?
I'm also going to say Scarlett Johansson. No, I'm kidding.
You're both wrong. No, I'm kidding. Go ahead.
Let's say... So, okay. Okay, I got it. I think I know. My
You're
final...
looking it up, aren't you?
No, I'm not. Good. Connor's right here, and she knows I'm not.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to say Jeff Bridges, and that is my final answer.
Who's that?
Miles is right. No, I'm kidding. Too much. Jeff Bridges is otherwise known as the dude. Jeff
From Bridges. Big Lebowski.
He is. He's quite the guy.
Yep, because I know what that is.
Quite the man.
Oh, you got to watch that because that's a funny movie. Yeah. No, Jeff Bridges is quite the actor. Mm-hmm. What else has he been in? He was the bad guy in the first Iron Man.
Oh, yeah. He was War Machine.
Ironmonger.
Not Ironmonger, yeah, sorry. He's War Machine.
Actually,
he was Ironmonger. No.
Did you even read comic books?
No.
Okay, so I know I'm wrong, but who was it supposed to be?
Is that your actual guess? Is Jeff Bridges?
It is, because I can't think of anyone else.
Think of someone, anyone. That's ideally a woman.
Ideally a woman. I said one. Come on.
Give me something here, Miles.
Judy Greer. I'll say Judy Greer.
Judy Greer.
I know terrible it's wrong. Guess.
No.
Yeah, I know it's a
terrible guess. It was actually Shailene Woodley, who was the main actress in the Detergent movies. I mean, Divergent.
I was
called Detergent. Yeah, Shailene. And she was also in Spectacular Now, things like that. Yeah, I would have never considered that to be a possibility too, but it makes sense after I guess it makes sense after.
I don't think I so, actually. It, she does not look like she could play that role. I mean, that's just me.
I don't know. I guess I could see it, maybe. I think they obviously went with the right choice with Brie, but, you know.
Yeah.
And then others that were actually considered before those two finalists was Emma Watson and Rooney Mara, actually. They were also considered for it.
Hmm.
Which is interesting. Now then, our sort of primary antagonist, at least for the first half, Old Dick, they call him Old Nick in the film. Do you know what this is a reference to? Or, like, what this means?
Santa, bring some gifts.
I was going to say the same thing, yeah.
Yeah, I'll take that for both of y'all. But also, there's another one, too, which is the devil, believe it or not. And I was looking into that.
His name's Lucifer.
Well,
let
yeah.
Let him explain, Connor.
It was just a nickname. Pun intended. It's a reference. Yeah, I guess it's a slang term in like a British slang term, believe it or not, for the devil. So, and I think that I was reading into this that our director was talking about that when he was thinking about what to call him. Well, I mean, I guess he's called that in the book too, obviously, but
mm-hmm.
like the meaning behind that was really interesting, and then that's why he wanted. I think the Jack to be a boy and not like his character to be a boy, not a girl, was because it kind of is contrasting with like this evil guy and then this sort of pure good child or boy, I guess I should say, to kind of contrast one another. And then also, of course, the devil along with the devil thing, sort of like Joy's kind of like Mary in this case, and Jack's sort of like, I guess, Jesus in the way that he's sort of supposed to be like pure and things, something like that, but it's a little religious, but no.
Interesting.
Even though he calls himself Samson.
Yeah, right.
Oh yeah.
I forgot about that.
Character.
Yeah. Now then. Interesting. But yeah, I'll take that answer for you guys because that is true. That is one of the references too. So, who wrote the screenplay for the film? Do you guys know?
No. I know Connor wouldn't, but even I know.
Okay. Okay.
The writer did.
Actually, that is true, believe it or not. But actually, yeah, it was Emma Donoghue who actually wrote the book. But she also wrote the screenplay for it.
Is that the question?
That was the question, yes.
Oh, okay.
We suck. If we do the Saw thing, I'm doing trivia.
Hell yeah.
Well, we just have to have Henry have access. All the songs.
Yeah. We'll figure it out.
Continue. Okay. Now, getting into some more classical movie trivia. Some old boys. I don't know if you guys are gonna get the last question. It's kind of, I don't know why I picked it. But before we get to that, which classic thriller movie? It was in the 70s. Stars Roy Scheider as Police Chief Martin Brody.
Oh, easy.
Yeah, Miles, you got this.
Connor, can you get this?
Halloween?
Good guess, but not quite.
It was Jaws, right?
Yes, Jaws.
Yeah, Jaws.
I wanted to include that this week because we were talking and directing. We've been dissecting the movie shot for shot. There's actually a lot to pack from it. the all the aesthetic choices they make. Even though it's just a monster movie, it's there's a lot to it, which Spielberg does a good job.
Yeah, the the zoom in, I don't remember what that's called, but I love when movies do that.
Are you talking about when he's on the beach and he sees like the
they change the focus while the
depth
zooming.
Of field too.
Yeah, the depth of field.
Well, because they get in, they truck in, the camera gets closer to the character, and then they zoom out is what they do. So the so it looks a lot further away than it really is, and it's a really fantastic trick. That's sort of a my directing teacher calls it a vertigo effect because we talked about the movie Vertigo. It's just sort of shots seem a lot longer and really harrowing. But anyways, so next question is our last question. I'd be really surprised if either of you, but so who was the first African-American actor to win the Academy Award for Best Actor?
African-American actor won Best...
You know, best the actor. Problem with this is I don't know names.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. It's
well, we can kind of help you if you can think of a movie they
were in. He was in Robin
Hood. Robin Hood? Like the... Oh, Jamie Foxx.
Yeah.
See, I know things. So you say Jamie Foxx. I'm gonna say Forrest Whitaker.
It's not bad. So his name is Sidney Poitier. Now he was in the movie he was in that he got not the award for Lee in the Fields, and that was in 1963. So that it's pretty far back, but I think the movies he was in was where there was one in particular. I'm trying to remember what it was, but we were talking about it in film history last semester where I think it was one of his films where it was the first that they managed to actually properly light an African American skin tone like on screen. Just because like before that the technology and they didn't really know how to do it. But yeah, he was the first person to win the award for best actor.
Interesting. Wow.
So yeah,
I have heard of him. I just
didn't. He's in a lot older, but
yeah.
As I was thinking of these questions, I forgot. I honestly forgot that Connor's going to be on the podcast, so I kind of made them a little difficult. Sorry, Connor.
It's okay. I tried.
You did good. You did good.
You did pretty good.
Yeah.
So who won, Henry? Were you keeping track?
Yes. As a matter of fact, I was. And Miles, you got half of them. So
wow, what a surprise! I got one.
But, I mean, the prize could be used for both of you. So
yeah,
that's great. So you guys both win, technically. Ooh. Yeah. Woohoo! Squad. Oh, I need to pick better trivia questions. Anyways, okay. So.
So it's everyone's favorite portion of the podcast, which is called Act Trivia.
Act Trivia. Oh, mama. Oh, yeah.
Okay, so this week, you are my contestant. How do you feel about that?
Pretty hot, to be honest. It's pretty hot.
Okay, oh, good. Let's see. What do you want this week, Henry? What do you want as a prize?
I want ice cream.
Okay. You're going to get pistachio-flavored ice cream.
You son of a bitch. I trust you.
You son of a bitch.
Pistachio ice cream? That's just nuts.
It's just... No, it's going to be just the shells. It's not going to be the...
Not even ice cream. It's just the pistachio shells.
No, okay. We crush the pistachio shells, drop them into milk, and call it ice cream.
That sounds like a really shitty cereal, basically, is what that is.
Oh, yeah, definitely. So it's just pistachio shell cereal.
One
pistachio.
Second.
Oh, man. What's up?
One second. Sorry. Poisoned by Alice Cooper randomly started playing for some reason.
We'll cut this bit out.
I I thought you were starting music for Act Trivia. I was like, oh, cool, you invented some cool rock music. But no, it was just my iTunes deciding to blare some random shit. Because why the hell not? All right, let's get on with Act Trivia.
As I was saying, pistachios.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
Okay. Okay, let's get started. You have 7 questions to answer.
7?
I think I've actually made them a little bit too hard, but we'll see.
Fuck.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. Okay. I'll get them all wrong.
Yeah, probably.
I'll be the first one to get them all wrong.
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
What
you got, Tim?
Okay, so the first... hold on. The first 3 are about Old Boy, and then the last 4 are a mixed bag.
Okay.
Okay, ready?
Yes.
Okay, that sucks, because I'm not going to start yet. You're actually ready.
Okay. How dare you know I was lying. All right. Okay. Now I'm sort of ready.
Okay, good. How many octopodes were eaten for the sushi bar scene?
Ooh, that's a good question. The answer, Miles, is actually 0, because it was actually CGI.
Is that your final answer?
No. No.
Because you were wrong.
I know. Jeez, Miles. I'm going to say 3.
Final answer?
Aye, Captain.
Okay, I'm sorry to say that was incorrect. But you were very close. It was 4.
Oh, son of a muffin.
Yeah. It was really interesting that apparently, what's his name? The guy who played Desu was Buddhist, so he had to pray pretty much every time he ate one. Because, you know, really? Buddhism, you're not allowed to eat meat. So he prayed every single time.
Hmm.
That's interesting. Okay. Number 2. Odesu, the old boy, was originated from what fictional character in Greek mythology? And you should know this.
Yeah.
I mean, you have heard of it anyway.
Yeah, right. What is it? Is that Oedipus?
Correct.
Oedipus the king?
Oedipus Wax.
Oedipus Wax. Okay. Cool.
Good job, good job, very good job.
1 second closer to my shitty cereal.
Yeah, you're ready for it.
Okay. Aye.
Number 3. This one, I'm a little worried, but I think you'll get it. In Old Boy, there are many examples of cosmic justice. Name the 2 most obvious ones, pretty much the ones that I wrote down. So I want you to name the 2 that I wrote down.
Wait, of cosmic justice?
Yeah. So like something at the beginning, and then kind of something to counteract it at the end. I'm trying to think. The one that you kind of said earlier would be a good example.
So, like, cosmic justice being just, like, you get what's coming to you, sort of?
Yeah.
So just, like, what examples of that there would be? So, obviously, we had... I mean, I think the biggest one was with his whole thing with our antagonist. What was his name? Jin or whatever.
Wu Jin.
Wu Jin. Because, I mean, that was the whole point, is he got retribution for that. So, because he was the one, I think, that told people, right? So,
mm-hmm. But, I don't know if that's quite cosmic justice, I guess. What do you mean? Do you mean Desu? The fact that Desu told people?
Yeah. I mean, because, like, I guess that was the whole point, right? Because he, the whole point of him getting retribution on Desu is because he was the one that told people all that. Okay. Because there's a whole thing about, yeah, like, it was his fault that all that stuff happened because he told people, and so.
Yeah, I mean, I guess. It. Some of the less obvious ones, I guess, is what I should have said.
Okay. Let me think, because what happened? Uh,
I can give you some clues because this is pretty hard. So the one that I wrote down, I wrote two down. So the first one is about Daisu, and the second one is about Mr. Han, who was the guy with the white hair.
Yeah. Han was, wait, was he like the guy that was like the right-hand guy to,
Wujin?
Yeah. Okay.
The white hair man.
Okay. Yeah, because his character was interesting, because I didn't really couldn't really quite grasp what was happening with that. But, so the first one involves Daisu.
And you can pass on this one, because I thought it was like, even I probably couldn't get it. And I'm much smarter than you, Henry.
True. yeah, I guess I'm going to pass on it.
Okay. That's totally fair. So the one that I wrote down, Daisu talks too much at the beginning, and then at the end he cuts his own tongue off.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That is pretty ironic.
And then, yeah, the other one was Mr. Han with the white hair. Here's everything Wujin did and does nothing, and at the end, he gets his ears stabbed and deafened. Thought that was interesting. And then I have a little side note here. If you noticed, the shot of Wujin when he holds his sister's hand is very similar to the scene in the beginning with Daisu holding the suicide man by the tie.
Yeah.
So that's also kind of a little bit of cosmic justice.
Huh. Go figure.
In a way. Okay, sorry.
That's okay.
That was a rough one.
It's good.
Okay, so now we're going away from Old Boyu. Okay, so this one is, you know, I give you some actors and you have to guess what movie it was.
Okay.
So Ryan Gosling, Emily Mortimer, and Paul Schneider star in what 2007 film?
Oh, let me think. Because I'm trying to think what he's been in.
I actually don't know if you've seen this one or not, but... And I guess, also, a girl named Bianca as well. Sorry, that's important too.
Wait, a girl named Bianca is in the story, or is that like an actual actress?
Sure, yeah.
Okay. what were the actors again?
Ryan Gosling, Emily Mortimer, and Paul Schneider, and then I guess Bianca as well.
And then I guess Bianca. That was I haven't seen it, but one of my friends has talked about it. Is it? So I'm trying to think. It's something to do with something like Lars and something.
Yeah.
Lars and the. I don't remember the last part of it. Something like that. I don't remember. I guess not.
Okay, that I'll take it. It's good enough. Lars and the Real Girl.
Oh, the real. That's right. Okay.
Mm-hmm. And Bianca is his mannequin doll.
Okay.
Maybe this will help.
I haven't actually seen it because my friend has talked about it though. So, okay.
That is also a good movie, I would say too. I enjoyed that. Okay, so now we have two logline questions.
Okay.
I think the first one will be easy. The second one's probably much harder because you probably haven't seen the second one. But, excuse me.
Nice.
I know, right? Okay.
That's pretty
a
hot.
Troubled teenager is plagued by visions of a man in a large rabbit suit who manipulates him to commit a series of crimes after he narrowly escapes a bizarre accident.
Donnie Darko.
Correct.
I love that movie.
Yeah, it's so good. I love it. And I think the way I saw it was somebody was like, oh man, you should see this movie, and I saw it, and now I'm like that to everyone else. I'm like, you gotta see this movie.
You gotta see this movie, man. I always thought that was interesting because I watched the director's cut of it, which I really enjoyed, and it was different than I thought it would be because on the cover, he's holding an axe on his shoulders, which, as you know, he uses to cut the water line or whatever in the school. And I, because I saw that, I was like, oh, is it going to be like some sort of like murder movie where he's like, he's enticed to murder people? But then I was like, not exactly. I mean, it's different. So it was, I liked it. Yeah. Anyways,
I've actually seen the director's cut, but
I don't think it's, I think that's the only one I think I've seen. I'd imagine it's probably just a little bit longer.
Yeah. Yeah.
The original cut is, but I don't know. Anyways, go ahead.
Okay. Number six. In order to get out of the snobby clique that is destroying her good girl reputation, an intelligent teen teams up with a dark sociopath.
Is that Heathers?
To kill the cool kids. Yes. Yes.
Nice. I love that movie too.
You've seen it?
Yep.
Wow. I wasn't expecting that.
Yeah. It was one my dad had mentioned years ago, and I'd never seen it. And then I think earlier this year I was on a movie education binge where I wanted to watch movies that most of my film friends had seen, but I hadn't. I was like, because it'd be like, we'd be talking about it, and be like, oh, this movie's really good. And I'm like, yeah, I've totally seen that. And so, yeah. And then that was when I watched. It was on Netflix. I don't know if it still is, but
I think, yeah, that's probably when I saw it too.
Yeah.
Good movie. I will look quickly if people want to go and watch that. Because, I mean, it's not like, I guess the ending is not very, you know what I mean? It's not, he's not very good for this current time period, I guess, just because, you know, a lot of school shootings and all that. But
yeah,
it is available on Tubi if you want to go watch it.
Mm-hmm.
Not on Netflix, though, it seems.
Yeah.
Okay.
Winona Ryder's very pretty now.
Oh yeah, she looks very good. yeah. Last question, and you'll probably, I don't know, actually, in Friends, the artwork in Central Perk changed every blank episodes. So how many times, like, every blank episodes, how many times did the artwork change in Central Park?
I gotta think. Was it... Okay, you don't have to answer, but I'm gonna ask anyway. Is it like really often, or would you say, or would it be like
not very often? I would say often. Yeah.
All right.
Less than 10, but less more than 1. 10?
All right.
But more than 1. Yeah.
The number failed me at the first question, but I'm gonna say it again. Is it 3 episodes?
Wow, boy, you're so good. Yeah, it's 3.
What? What?
Yeah. Yeah.
What?
Yeah. Well, you did much better than I thought you would, honestly.
I don't know. That cosmic justice question still gets me.
Yeah, 5 out of 7.
5 out of 7? Do I get that shitty cereal then?
Yes, you do. You
broken
win
up pistachios.
The pistachios.
O's? Okay. Alright. Alright. Point of reminders.
Congratulations.
Yay! I did it. What did I win?
Your mom.
Oh my gosh.
Shiny. Oh god.
Oh, pistachio, oh god.
Okay.
So it is time for the main event of the night. And that is, drum roll please.
Bada bum, bada bum. How's that?
Do you hear me? I'm coming.
I mean, it sounds like you're just tapping your fingers on your desk or something, but
no, it doesn't. You're gonna edit that out, right?
No.
It's just silence.
Way too much work.
okay, it's time for
Jesus.
Act trivia.
It's time for Jesus. Go ahead.
No.
Act trivia.
Time for Jesus.
Act trivia.
So, all right, Miles, I've got 5 questions on the clock.
Oh my god.
Now, actually, I did have one thing to say. I went to an escape room, by the way.
Oh, really?
Yeah. We lost, though. Cool. We didn't make it out in time.
I don't think I've ever been in an escape room before that I've won.
Really?
Yeah. And I've been to, like, 3.
Oh, really? You have that many?
Yeah.
Is it just you and Connor that go, or, like...
Sorry, I just hit the mic. the 2 times, it was just Connor and I, and then the 3rd time, it was with friends.
So, like,
well, actually, the third time we might have won. I just don't remember. But I barely helped.
So, like, Jennifer Aniston was there, Courtney Cox was there, Lisa Kudrow, Matthew Perry, they were all there.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
The friends.
The whole crew.
The FRIENDS were there.
Yeah.
Really? And how does that make you feel?
Kind of odd, since I'm not part of the show.
Why is that?
I don't know, man.
Interesting.
Okay.
Fascinating stuff.
Dude,
from a man who just has a podcast.
Okay.
Oh, sorry. So now there's 5 questions that are on the clock, like I said. And if you win the game, I will give you the rest of this concrete mixer that's sitting here on my desk.
Is it melted?
It's melted.
Okay, good. That's how I like them.
Yeah. And it's also just got a shot of my...
You also, what?
Yeah. It's also got a shot of my jizz in there. Anyways.
That's what I thought you were going to say.
Yeah, I pussied out at the last second. But then I said it. Anyway, so...
Good,
I
don't know. Good.
I'm learning, Miles. I'm sorry. Alright. Conveniently, I'm sorry is what I say after sex. Okay, so technically, a scene change is when they're in a different location. This is a little bit of an exception to the rule, but what was the longest scene in the entire movie?
Like, uncut, kind of?
No, just I mean, because a scene can have different cuts. It's just... it's all in one location specifically. Okay. So what is the longest scene in the entire movie? I referenced it earlier, I think.
I would say second. I know this isn't what you're asking for, but the second one would probably be the Drew Barrymore scene, but the first one is probably the house at the end.
Yes. Yeah, specifically that party scene. Scene 118 is what it was called, and looks like it took 42 minutes of the movie, which I guess they're counting as the whole party scene.
Yeah.
Is what they're talking about there. Which, I mean, I guess you could kind of consider it to be a little bit debatable, because they do go outside for a portion of it. And generally, at least from what I've learned from film school, they consider a scene change when they go to a different location. And, I mean, technically, I guess it's like, still... Yeah. They'd still be at the same house property, I guess. But, I mean, they're also outside, so I would consider that a little bit different.
Yeah.
Either way, that's a really long scene. Anyway, you got that right. Good job, Miles.
Cool.
Okay. Ding. Now, Miles. Next one. Oh, by the way, these are all just related to the movie. I just kept it contained to this for today. Because okay, cool. I knew that you liked the movie so much.
Before we even talked, you're right.
Yeah. I'm what they call a psychic. Psychic. There are 6 rules for surviving a horror movie, as stated in the film.
Oh, God.
Can you name half of them?
Yes, I'm gonna try. Okay.
Alright.
You said 6?
Yes, in total.
Okay. Don't drink alcohol. Or wasn't it don't do drugs and alcohol?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's one.
Don't have sex.
That's one. You just need one more to get half.
Yeah. Let's say... I want to say don't go off alone.
Yeah.
Like that's what I would say, even if it's not, but...
No, that's right. I mean, I'll take that. Technically, I mean, I guess they specifically said it as no saying, like, I'll be right back, and then going off on your own. But,
oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's one of them. So I'll take that.
I'll be right back.
Yeah, I know, right? That was so funny.
no, yeah, that was so funny. Okay.
That was really funny. Now, can you name, for bonus points, can you name the rest of them?
No, dude, I don't remember the rest.
Okay. Well, the last one that was stated by that horror movie nerd was everyone is a suspect. And then the last two actually came from the killers, when they said, never call out who's there, for one. And then the other one is never investigate a weird noise.
Oh, yeah.
So, which is, yeah. But yeah, good job, Miles. I'm giving that one to you, too. So Yay. Far, you're two for...
Two for zero. What?
Three. Who was initially offered the role of Sydney? Sydney was our main character in the movie Scream.
Do you think you can give me a hint?
Yeah. Actually, let me make sure I got the right person first.
Oh, okay.
Before I'm pretty sure I know who this is, but let me double check. Let's find out, shall we?
I guess, yeah.
Shall we, Miles? Are you sure?
No.
Alright, so, she was in, I feel like this is gonna give it away, but whatever.
It probably will.
She was in, a lot of 80s movies, including 16 Candles and Pretty in Pink.
I like, before you even said the two movies, I'm like, I'm gonna say Molly Ringwald.
Yeah! Actually, that was right.
Yeah.
How did you know, Miles?
Because I know my movie trivia, bruh.
Oh my gosh. Say that again.
I'm good.
Okay. Now, clearly we talked about it earlier, but Scream makes references to several different horror-related movies.
Yeah.
In terms of cliches, what horror movie does Scream make the most references towards?
Halloween.
Dude, you're on freaking fire. This might be the first episode where you get a perfect. But we'll find out.
Where I get what? Sorry, I think
a purse. Where you get a purse.
Oh, a purse. Oh, that's what you said.
No, where you get it all perfect. Oh, all five perfect. Questions right. Let's find out.
Next time on...
Come back and finish the episode later. You know what? It might not matter, though, because I'm probably going to finish this concrete mixer by the time we're done with this.
Yeah, probably. I'll take the cup and the spoon, please.
You know, it's kind of disturbing to think about, because I technically said earlier that it contains my sperm. So, you know, technically I'm, you know, whatever.
You're drinking your own sperm. Go ahead.
I've done worse. So, now, Stu is played by Matthew Lillard, who plays Shaggy in the Scooby-Doo movie.
Of course, yeah.
What other movie actor in the movie Scooby-Doo, also, or was in the movie Scooby-Doo, also auditioned for Stu? So it might be a little more difficult, but...
Yeah. I don't know his name. Fuck.
That's right. His name is Ah Fuck.
I don't know his real name, but I'm gonna say Fred, I guess, who played Fred.
Close. His name is not Fred. Actually, no, you're right.
That's not what I said.
His name is... Actually, his name is Fred, though.
In real life?
Freddie Prinze Jr.
Freddie Prinze Jr. I know his name, okay? I just didn't...
His name actually is Fred, though, so you technically got that right.
I know.
Just saying. Now, I'm just going to say this right now. Miles is the first ever person to get all the trivia questions right. Let's give him a round of applause.
We finished already?
Yeah, I only did five.
Oh, yeah, yeah. No, yay! Woohoo! Good. Those were kind of easy, though.
Yeah, they were pretty easy. You know what, Miles? I try, okay?
Yeah, I mean, if you watch the movie, at least, it's not too bad.
It's not that difficult. Yeah, I kept them all contained in the movie. If we went into, like, television or other random movies, probably be a little bit more. You know what, Miles? That's true.
No one wants to get fucked, right?
Miles, just quit talking about how handsome you are, okay? We get it.
Yeah. Just look at the image you're seeing on screen right now of me, the one on the left.
What if they're, like, listening to it, like on one of the podcast platforms and then you can't see an image.
Well, then you look at the cover image that's on there.
Or you just think of Miles' body, and that's it.
Supple, supple breasts.
Supple butt. yeah, but that's literally it.
Okay, that's good. Yeah, all I got. Woo.
Yeah, ooh, you get my,
cup of sperm.
Concrete sperm mixer.
Sperm mixer.
Sperm mixer, yep.
Yeah. All right. What was the thing we were... Oh, yeah, we finished the question.
We're done with that. So now, time for more questions?
Yes, but in a different format.
In act trivia.
Dude, you gotta let me say it. I'm the one who's...
Oh, sorry. Take it back. I take it back.
Henry, I'm going to fire you if you ever try and do something like that again.
Okay. Act trivia.
That was like the goofiest laugh I've ever made. You're good. Okay, let's see. Start here.
I mean, you can do the actual goofy laugh too.
I could, but I won't.
Yeah.
Okay. Ready. This week we're doing a new thing. It's called Act Trivia.
Shit. Here we go again.
Shit. Oh shit. And this week, hold on, fuck, you're going to get, let's see, if you win, you get, let me look around my room, find something funny, an empty pickle jar with water in it. I guess it's not empty.
You can put some tissues in it.
No. Oh, yeah. I literally, like, as I was saying the phrase pickle jar, I was like, wait, I already made that joke.
Yeah.
No. How about... Shit, man.
Did you look downstairs?
My room isn't funny. Oh, downstairs? Yeah. I've got nothing in my diaper, so...
Nice.
What
about the diaper itself?
The diaper itself? Oh, you want my used diaper?
Oh, shit.
It's one of those, like, classic ones where you have to, like, wash it. And then you have to reuse it with, like,
a thing?
Yes. Have you ever seen that before?
Never have.
Oh, my God. Okay, so, like, you know in old cartoons when they had diapers that just had a clothespin in it?
Yeah.
That's what that is. It's pretty much just a cloth, and you have to wash it every time it's used.
Okay.
And how you put it around, you know, the baby is with a clothespin.
Right.
But then, you know, they came out with diapers that you just throw out when you're done with them.
Oh, I thought you were gonna say throw up, like you eat them and then you vomit them.
Yeah. No, you vomit into the diaper. No, wait.
And then eat it.
It's like a Bane mask for your face. There's a new invention for drunk people.
It's like a Bane mask for your face? That's just a Bane mask.
But for vomit.
Oh, okay.
A Bane mask for vomit, sorry. Which would be really gross because the vomit's like inches away from your mouth. you take the diaper off your face and it's just covered in vomit.
What are we talking about?
Okay. Oh, you get my used diaper, all right? Let's just start.
I'll take that.
Cool. All right. I have 6 questions.
All right.
4 of which are about the film Killer Clowns from Outer Space.
Okay.
And I also have, before I start, I have a little fact that I couldn't work into a question, but I thought was really interesting.
Okay.
So, I'm just going to say it now.
Say it.
That I probably should have said earlier with the review portion, but I did not.
Vampire.
So, you know when Debbie, the female protagonist, takes a shower?
Yeah.
She's wet. And naked. it lasts 20 minutes of screen time.
Okay.
So, you know... like stuff happens in between the shots of her being in the shower, which potentially could have been hours of time. So that means that Debbie took the longest shower in cinema.
Oh my gosh.
Because it took like hours for everyone, like, you know, they're getting chased by clowns and stuff. A bunch of stuff happens. They're driving around town. And all this time, she's just taking a shower.
That's funny.
It's the longest shower ever. It's the
longest shower ever, dude.
It's so... I just thought it was funny and worth mentioning. All right. First question. I worded it in a really weird way, so I'm going to try and get through it. What was the first day of recording the music score in 1987? See, I worded it in such a weird way. In 1987, they recorded the music score, all right? So what was the first day of recording? And it's, you know, it's a little bit, like, if you really think about it, it's, I'll give you a hint, it's a holiday.
It's a holiday?
Yeah.
October 31st.
Correct.
Wait, really? Oh, okay, cool.
Yes, see, I was like, you gotta get this one, it's easy, boy.
It's easy money.
All right. Number two. Who played King Clown, or as it's, I think, named in the movie or whatever, Clownzilla from The Crew?
From The Crew?
Oh, yeah, it was a person from The Crew.
Yeah. Oh, I know this one, too. Charles something? Charles, his last name.
Chiodo?
Chiodo, yeah, that guy.
Yeah, it was Charles Chiodo, brother to the director, who... That's right, Charles, yeah, his last Charles name was also a writer as well.
Oh, he was a writer for it? Okay.
Yeah, and I think it's a three-brother...
Yeah, because wasn't the production company like the Chode Brothers or something?
The Chode Brothers?
No?
Yeah, no, you got it right, the Chode Brothers.
All right, what's next? We got a couple minutes, but then I gotta go.
Okay. What did Charles Chiodo cover the inflatable dog with to prevent it from popping?
Oh, I don't know. Latex.
Correct.
Wait, really? Oh, okay.
Cool. Yes, very good job. Okay. What was the most expensive prop in the film that actually worked?
That actually worked?
Yeah. Ooh, I don't know. It kind of did what it was supposed to.
I'm trying to think of everything that was in there.
It was something used by the clowns, by the way.
Right.
Excuse me.
Was it... you're saying, wait, was it like what... like effect? Special effect? Or like practical effect?
It was an actual prop.
It was an actual prop.
Yeah, that was used in the film that actually, you know, did its job. Kind of.
Is it... I'm trying to remember everything that was used. I don't know. Actually, I don't know. Go ahead.
It was the popcorn gun.
It was the popcorn gun? Okay.
Yeah, it cost $7,000 alone. Oh my gosh. Damn. Yeah. All right, next question. Let's see what we have here. A journalist? Okay, wait, hold on. So these are log lines. The last two questions are log lines.
Oh, I love these questions.
I bet you do.
I do.
Do you?
Yes.
Oh, cool. Okay. First one. A journalist must investigate a mysterious videotape which seems to cause the death of anyone 1 week to the day after they view it. Perfect. I figured you would get that. That's an easy question.
That one's relatively... Is the next one harder?
Maybe. I don't know if you've seen it or not. It's,
Let's find out.
Yeah. Okay. It's not a movie, I'll tell you that.
Oh.
Flashing between past and present, a fractured family confronts haunting memories of their old home and the terrifying events that drove them from it.
Ooh, okay. So you said it's not a movie, so is it like a TV show, then?
Maybe, yeah.
Okay, yeah. That's a yes. let's see.
I can give you one more hint, if you need it.
Go ahead.
It is on Netflix.
It is on Netflix, okay. Alright, I'm gonna jump on Netflix real quick, just a second. let me see.
I can read it again if you need.
No, it's okay, I got it. I just gotta think.
I bet you thinking is just you looking up.
No. Yeah, right. So it's definitely not The Office.
Definitely not The Office.
No, let me see. I don't think I've seen it. So, I don't know.
Okay.
What you got?
You want me to give you the answer?
Go ahead.
It is The Haunting of Hill House.
Haunting of Hill House. Okay.
Have you heard of this one?
I have never seen it, though.
Oh, wow. I would actually recommend you watch this one, even if it's just, like, outside of the podcast, you know, or something. Because I actually did enjoy this one. Mm-hmm. I think there's, like, one or two episodes that stand out from the rest. But besides that, it's pretty good.
So, like, two that are kind of bad, I mean?
No, two that are better than the rest. One or two. I don't remember, but
the rest of it's pretty good too. Okay.
Yeah, and I think they're coming out with another season. It's going to be like a different family, a different story. It's going to be kind of like an anthology series, I guess.
Okay.
I'm uncertain though, so I don't know.
Gotcha.
Okay, so you got that last one wrong. But you got all the rest right, so you win the prize, dude. You win. You win my full diaper.
Yeah.
My diaper, that's full.
I'm going to put it up on my wall.
Staple it?
Yeah.
Or no, hammer it so that it bothers your brother.
Exactly. Or I could give it to him to wear the hat.
That's disgusting. Disgusting!
Disgusting.
Oh, wow. Dude, good job. That was really close to being full, like, getting them all right.
I know. I came so close.
It has yet to happen for you, but last week it happened to me.
Yes, it did happen to you. Beware. It could happen to me, too.
Mm-hmm. It happened to anyone.
Yes.
I have nothing else. Henry, what about you?
I have something else for you, Miles.
A gift?
Yes. The gift of Ek Trivia.
Oh my god.
Are you ready now?
No. Okay. Can we do this? Can we do it later, actually?
No.
Okay, cool. Let's do it now.
Wait, were you being serious?
No.
Okay, I was like, wait, do you need to go to bed? Is it your bedtime? Okay, it's so I have seven questions for you, and if you win, Miles, if you answer at least four questions correctly.
Oh my god.
I will give you my wallet.
What?
My wallet.
With everything inside of it?
No.
I don't want it then.
Well, too bad. You better not get them all right then.
Yeah, I'll try not to, I promise.
You'll be so... You won't even know what the answers to the questions that you'll just guess, but you'll get them all right anyways. Just watch. And then you'll have to take the wallet.
I'll just say numbers for every single one, and they're all like...
Correct. We'll just put in that sound effect from SpongeBob where Plankton's like, correct. And that's the Bank East episode, I think. Yeah. Anyways. All right. Seven questions, Miles. We've got 60 seconds on the clock.
No.
Oh, shit.
Okay.
I'm not doing that.
We could do that, Miles.
We could, but that's a lot of work and effort, and I don't feel like it.
This is random, but did you watch the Between Two Ferns movie?
I want to. I think we should have that as a podcast movie, because I haven't seen it yet.
It'd be funny, because there's like this one point where he refers to an extreme close-up as an Iku, because it's ECU, and I just think it was so funny. I don't know why, because like, I know like what those abbreviations are meant to be, and how they, you know, when you're working on a movie, how to, you know, shoot mm-hmm. frame those and stuff, and I just thought that was so funny. He's like, you said we could do an EQ. I'm like this. And I was like, oh my gosh. He's like, you mean extreme close-up? And I just thought that was so funny. Okay. Anyways, 7 questions.
On the clock.
Infinite time on the clock.
Yeah.
Question number 1. Oh, yeah. 3 of these questions are about the children of
the porn.
And then the other, what did you say?
The porn.
Oh my, the...
That's bad. Never mind.
I thought you said the bum. I was like, oh my gosh.
That's not even funny.
No. you're not even funny.
I know.
So the rest are 90s trivia, actually.
Interesting. Interesting.
So I chose a certain decade. Anyways, 1. What car did Bert and Vicky drive in Children of the Corn?
Oh my god. I don't even know types of cars. I'm going to guess and say it was a Cadillac.
Correct. No, I'm kidding.
Oh, good.
So it was a 77 Buick LeSabre.
Wow.
So that was something. All right.
Yeah,
now.
That was something. A question that I was never be able to answer.
Yeah, actually, well, you did technically answer it, so you just lied.
Correctly.
You answered it incorrectly a bit, yeah.
Shut the fuck up.
Roasted. 2. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
I mentioned this guy earlier because I thought his voice was really funny, but John Franklin played Isaac,
mm-hmm.
who was like, I don't know what age he was, like the kid, but he was, how old was he when he filmed Children of the Corn? The actor, not like the character.
The actor? I'm going to say 20, because I think... Like, they didn't really start doing children acting besides... I mean, okay, you know what? I'm going to say 18. 18, final answer.
You are incorrect, actually.
Okay, cool.
He was 24.
Wow. Yeah. That is fucking insane.
I read that and I was like, dang. Which made it even funnier for me that his voice was so high.
I'm sorry, dude, but... Your voice is way too high.
Do not persecute me, Malachi. <That's funny. laughs> I just think it's so funny.
Yeah.
Anyways, all right, 3. Hemmingford, which is the place they were trying to reach, that Bert and Vicky were trying to reach before they finally went to Gatlin,
mm-hmm. Yeah.
was also referenced in what Stephen King novel?
Like a different novel?
Yeah, there's a different one that... he wrote where it was mentioned.
Let's say it.
As a matter of fact, are you ready for the answer, Miles?
I'm incorrect.
As a matter of fact, it actually was referenced in it. It was mentioned.
Was that the answer that you were looking for?
That wasn't quite what I was going for, but you know what? Actually.
Okay.
It was it technically just I would count it because, you know, it was, I think it was mentioned very briefly.
Wow. What was the one you were looking for though?
I don't know, hold on.
Oh my god.
Hold on, I gotta look at my notes. 1 sec. 1 minute, I had it. Hold on.
I'm holding.
Okay, hold on.
I'm holding.
Okay, Miles. Miles okay?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dude, why is this taking so long?
I'm sorry, I kind of forgot where I wrote it down.
Oh my god.
I took a lot of stuff, okay.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, okay, you know what? The Stand is what it was.
Oh, yes, Stand By Me.
Yeah, that's close.
Wait, is that... No, The Body is the Stand By Me one. Okay,
yes.
The Stand. Do I know that one? That wasn't made into a movie, was it?
I don't think it was, no.
Okay, then I don't know it. Okay, so I got that one right. Awesome,
yeah,
kind of.
I'll give it to you. Okay.
Loser points.
Time for some 90s trivia.
Yay.
You gotta get all these right, Miles. You ready?
No.
This one shouldn't be too bad. What 97 film stars Nicolas Cage, John Cusack, and John Malkovich?
97 film?
Yes.
Oh, crap. Fuck. 97 film. I don't think he was in it, but I know Being John Malkovich is with John Cusack and John Malkovich. And I think that one came out in, like, 2003, 2005 or something. I don't think I know this one, and I probably do, which sucks.
I think you've probably heard of it, at least if you haven't seen it.
Any other hint or no?
I don't think there's anything else I can say that wouldn't give it away.
If not, I'm just gonna give up, I guess.
The title is two words, if that helps, I guess.
Two words. Nope, I got nothing. Go ahead.
It was Con Air.
Fuck! I was just gonna say that, but, like, only because Nicolas Cage, like, I didn't even know John Cusack or John Malkovich was
actually in that. I didn't know that they were in it either, to be honest, until I read that.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah. Have you seen that? Have you seen Con Air?
No, dude.
Okay, I haven't either. knowing Nicolas Cage, I'm sure that's probably a good thing. just kidding. Okay, so now, which 90s movie soundtrack is the best-selling soundtrack of all time?
The best-selling music soundtrack of all time? Or the best, like, 90s soundtrack?
Of all time.
Of all time. So, like, all the soundtracks?
Yes. Okay. Even by today's standards, there's still, I think, the best.
Okay.
It's earned the most money, I should say.
Okay. Can I ask, is it from a musical? I'm guessing no.
I don't think it's a musical.
Yeah. Okay. Fuck, dude, you asked some really hard questions this week.
Yeah, I kind of had to make up for last time.
I bet. I'm gonna say
it's a romantic thriller, I guess.
Romantic thriller. Well, that doesn't help me. I can't think of anything.
It's okay. Romantic. I don't know if you've seen this one. I haven't seen it for sure. So.
Yeah, I guess why don't you go ahead? I'm not in it this week. Go ahead.
It was The Bodyguard. It came out in
92. Oh, yeah.
Okay. Starring Whitney Houston, and it actually features five of her hit singles. So.
Wow.
All right, now.
I have not seen that, by the way.
I haven't either. okay, number six. I don't know if you've... I haven't seen this one. Okay. What was Robin Williams' first animated film?
Like in the 90s? Film.
Yes.
I'm guessing?
Yes.
It wasn't Aladdin.
Nope.
No? Oh. Okay. Thank you for helping me.
You're welcome.
Fuck. I should know this. I've probably seen it. Oh, fuck. Any hint or no? Because I can probably get it if I get a hint, but...
I don't think I really... Since I haven't seen it, I don't really know enough about the movie to...
Okay.
Really see anything, which just goes to show how much I researched. let me see if I can look at it. Tim Curry voices in it too. I don't know if that helps.
That doesn't, but I feel like it should.
I would say it came out in 92, but I already said that. yeah, I can't really say anything else, I don't think, without giving it away.
Okay. It wasn't a Disney movie, right?
No, I don't think so.
Okay. I guess just go ahead. Wow. I really am sucking this week. Go ahead.
This was Fern Gully, The Last Rainforest.
Yeah, I have not seen that one either, so I don't feel bad.
I didn't even, when I read that, I was like, what even is this movie? But yeah.
I've heard of it, I think. But
yeah, I haven't. It's an animated musical fantasy film, so that's interesting. Wow. Number seven.
You brought it hard.
Go ahead. Seven. Who said... Who said the famous line, "Do you understand the words that are coming out of my mouth?" And in what movie?
Oh, dude, that's easy. Yeah. This is the only question I'm going to get right this week. Rush Hour. Another
one. All right, and then who
was the actor? Two, right. That was Chris Tucker saying that to Jackie Chan.
Heck yeah, he was.
Do you understand the words that are coming out of my mouth?
Yeah.
What a good one. So good.
I love that movie.
Yeah.
Wow.
What is it good for?
Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Miles, right. Wow.
Sadly, you did not win Act Trivia this week, which means you did not get my wallet, but
you
get everything inside of it.
Awesome. Wait. Yes. Thank you.
So you can assume my identity.
I can steal your
live a really boring life. You see all those like memes on like Instagram where it's like really sad because it's like someone like steals your identity and then they're like end up like crying in a car or something, like, how do you live like this? And it's just like, okay. it's gonna be okay.
So I lost.
Yes, you did.
I did. And
you know what? We lost, Miles.